The road to the driverless car has been a long one.
We're all set for auto control.
This is how General Motors envisioned the future back in 1957.
You're now under automatic control, hands-off steering.
That was then, this is now. Nissan's race for the first autonomous production vehicle is in the hands of top Japanese engineer Tetsuya Ijima, who had me figure out how it works.
These are your laser scanners.
Yes.
And they send out big beams of laser.
Yes.
And to determine how far the distance is.
Yes.
And then here we have a big radar panel that can see 200 meters ahead.
Yes.
And in the back of the car, we have another radar panel here.
Mm-hmm.
And one over here as well.
Yeah.
And they determine
70 meters.
70 meters?
Yes.
Whether objects are approaching a car or going away from the car.
Yes.
And then all of these little guys are for parking. They're sonar.
Yes.
So they send out little chirps. And then you have cameras on every side of the car?
Yes.
This is a normal Nissan Leaf, but it's totally a prototype.
Yes.
So
if
I open this up, you can see all of the...
This is kind of a secret. Don't touch
it. I won't touch it. We're going to put autonomous mode. That's the autonomous button.
Yes.
Hit it.
Yes.
Autonomous mode activated.
So you have no hands. The camera's reading the speed limit sign now.
And input to the system.
And we're going to watch it slow down.
Yes, yes. Automatically.
Red light.
The
camera's detecting it.
Signal is red.
Car says signal's red.
Signal is green.
Now, it's not a color camera. How did it know?
Yeah, position.
Just the position of the
position.
Lights. The system explains what it's doing so the driver's not confused ever.
Yeah.
How did it know to go left now instead of going to the right?
Because reading the right.
It reads all those lines.
Yes.
So it follows the road using the cameras. And what happens if a kid comes out chasing a ball?
Oh!
Oh my God! Oh my God!
Wow.
We almost killed that guy. Thanks, car. It checks to see if there's anyone behind us, anyone next to us.
Mm-hmm.
It makes a decision whether to brake or swerve. Yeah. Can we park it now?
Yeah.
And we can do that from the back seat, right?
Yeah. This is my space.
It's calling dibs on that spot, and now it's parking. And the I love watching the steering wheel just spin itself. What happens if I interrupt it?
Stops. Completely stops.
It will completely stop, and now it's going to go back from where it started.
Yes.
How many years till that's in all cars?
2020. By 2020.
As car makers head toward that date, the biggest obstacle may not be the technology, but the human factor. At Stanford University's Automobile Lab, they're using a state-of-the-art simulator to answer the question, how fast can drivers react when they're thrust back in control of an autonomous car?
What is the most dangerous time in an autonomous car?
The moment when the car shifts control from itself to the driver. Drivers are totally disoriented, and they're being asked to absorb an enormous range of activities, an enormous range of things going on, to get what we call situation awareness, where there was none. And that turns out to be an extraordinary challenge.
I am going to be placing the EEG electrodes on your head.
Because we want to really understand what's going on in your brain and in your body and when you're driving. We also hook up the driver. We can see where their eyes are looking because we have an eye tracker.
They look great.
What their brain is doing at various points. We can see what their heart is doing.
This simulator was built to help us better understand ways to alert the driver that autonomous mode is being switched.
After several minutes of texting while the car is driving, watch what happens when I have to take control.
Please disable automation.
Car just asked me to disable automation. What? Why did the computer just decide to not? Uh-oh. I just crashed in about 12 cars because I wasn't paying attention. I was going really fast. So while I was hooked up, you were measuring my brain waves. You had sensors on my hands determining, like, what was that doing?
So that's what's called autonomic arousal. So it has to do with how essentially excited you are, how ready for action you are. And a good driver is neither too excited nor too calm.
Will we be required to be plugged into the car so it knows what we're doing?
Definitely not. Eventually, Cars will completely drive themselves.
Making the car the designated driver promises to revolutionize how we get around. But for Steve Mahan, who is almost completely blind, and others whose disabilities keep them from driving, the cars will completely transform their lives.
Auto driving.
Google gave Steve a glimpse of the future, inviting him to take the driver's seat in their first autonomous vehicle.
Look, Ma, no hands.
How'd that feel?
Incredibly normal and abnormal at the same time.
So the car was doing its thing. Did you have any instinctual responses?
All the things that you do as you drive just immediately come back.
So we're here at the stop sign.
Yep.
Even though you can't see?
Even though I can't see.
Hey, anybody up for a taco?
I suggested that we go to Taco Bell because that's a normal thing that I would do.
This is some of the best driving I've ever done.
Do you think that you'll be able to be driving again in your lifetime?
Absolutely.
Only on Al Jazeera America.
A team of scientists are taking their inspiration from nature.
Technology, it's a vital part of who we are.
They had some dynamic fire behavior.
And what we do.
Transcranial direct stimulation. Don't try this at home.
TechKnow's team of experts show you how the miracles of science.
This is my selfie. What can you tell me about my future?
Can affect and surprise us.
Sharks like affection.
Catch new episodes of TechKnow on Al Jazeera America. Check your local listings or visit aljazeera.com.